Hi, my name's Tobias Fairlove. I've been a yurt maker for the best part of 20 years now, and I'm going to show you how to put your yurt up in this short video. So take some time to position your ground sheet properly, taking into consideration the prevailing wind directions and the lay of the land.
In this case, this yurt has three trellises or kana. Yours might have two, three or four. It also has 40 roof poles or roof ribs, which means there are 40 holes or sockets in the roof wheel and 40 points at trellis height to which you attach your roof poles.
Make sure you've got the correct overlap, which in my yurt is like so. You're forming a V, so two of these tips or points overlap each other. So once you've got the correct overlap, wrap your cords securely around and tie them. I always find it's best to tie them in a bow so that when you come to take your yurt down, the process is a bit more speedy. So the next stage is to fit your door. In this yurt, we've got wooden doors with the door frame attached to it. Sometimes you'll have just a coppice door frame on its own with a canvas door, or you might have a wooden door frame and then you hang the doors on afterwards. Whatever setup you've got, the principle is the same. So you take your door over to the yurt and then you tie your trellis into the door frame, and usually there are holes drilled into the door frame to which to attach your ties. And a similar principle as with tying the trellises together. If you can, it's always best to tie in a bow. So if you get someone to just hold it for you, it's really useful. Next, we fix the second door, same process as the first. So you tie them in all the way down, nice and tightly. And I'm just gonna move that. And then take the head and fix it to the top of the door. So the next stage is to fit the tent band. This runs from door to door around the top of the walls. Cool. Okay, so if I can give this to my assistant, it's useful if someone can hold that for you. And then this fixes at the door frame. You can go, and then it goes around the outside perimeter of the yurt at the top of the wall height. And if the tent band begins to drop down, every seventh or eighth one, you can just hook it over one of the tips or the points of the trellis there, and it'll stop it from falling down to the ground. So if it seems like it's a bit short, don't worry about it, because at this stage, it's relatively easy to pull the tent band in nice and tight. And lastly, before we put the wheel up, we need to ensure that the ground sheet cord is tied to the door frame. It needs to be taut but not ridiculously tight. So the next stage in the process of putting up your yurt is the wheel. So for this, we need to form a tripod. So you need to take three of your sturdy roof poles and position them equidistantly around the outside of the yurt. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And 1, 2, 3, 4. One in the middle of the door, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So we know we're right, and next we get the wheel. And then next we take the wheel, and then it's useful if you have someone inside the yurt to just give you a hand at this point too, to hold the wheel in position. Tie this to the top of the trellis, and then if you you come there. Make sure that's correctly positioned. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Tie roof pole number 2 in the right place, and then at this point it's a one person job, so it's best to ask if your assistant would stand out of the way, and then you take the roof pole and push the wheel up into the air. If the wheel isn't as level as you'd like it, the way to level it out is to attach roof poles in the upper side and pull them down with the roof poles, as I'll demonstrate. It's a little bit high on this side. If you take another roof pole here and fix it more or less in the middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and where it was a little bit high, you can just pull it down a little bit there. So now we fill in the rest of the roof poles. It's not a bad idea to, when you put the next three in, so you've got six in altogether, is to position these second batch of three in the middle of your tripod, and that keeps the wheel much more evenly balanced. A bit like fitting the nuts on the wheel of a car. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 2, 4, 6. Once you've got six in, the wheel will be very secure and stable, and then you can just fill the rest, the remaining, in this case, 34 roof poles in. Just bearing in mind, though, that over the door frame, over the doorway, there'll be the roof poles will nearly always be slightly shorter. In this instance, we've got three roof poles on top of the doorway. That's quite standard. So we've got three slightly shorter ones, which I'll fit now. So when you've fitted all of the roof poles into your yurt, the next stage is to begin to fit the canvas cover. You might want to have an assistant to do that. So we'll position the main roof canvas at the front door. Secure your hauling rope at the hauling point on the roof canvas. What we're going to do is we're going to drag the main roof canvas up from the door, the head of the door frame, up to the roof wheel. Okay, so when you've got the roof canvas sitting on top of the door frame, then you get your assistant to go around to the back of the yurt. With the hauling rope, flick the hauling rope up over the top of the yurt. That's it, like so. And then you pull the roof canvas up to the wheel rim. It's also useful to have a poking pole so you can poke the canvas from the inside. That's it, brilliant. Okay, we're there. So at this point, you either hold this rope or secure it to the trellis. So we've got the canvas in position now. It's a bit like it's a slice of cake coming from the door frame up to the wheel rim. And then we're going to unfurl the canvas halfway round the yurt. Okay, brilliant. So if there's some ties on your door canvas, you might want to tie them to your door frame or to the roof poles as in this situation to stop the canvas from moving around. So the next stage is to haul your second, to secure your second hauling rope to the back part of your canvas. And it's a bit like the repetition, it's a bit like you're repeating the first process. You give the rope, take the rope to the back of the yurt, and with a combination of them pulling the rope and you easing the canvas, you work it up and over. Yeah, it's going good. The next stage is to tie off the wall cord, which will be either wrapped around the door frame or there'll be a hole drilled in the door frame to which to tie it to. The wall cord is positioned here, goes between the two draft flaps in the roof canvas. This situation it's black and is used to hang the walls off. You hook the walls onto the wall cord like so. So we're nearly there now. The final process is to drag the roof cap, which covers the crown or the wheel, or the Mongolian term is the tunduk, that covers the tunduk. We're going to drag and pull that wheel, that roof cap cover over the yurt, and then we're going to peg it down. So I'll just go through that process with you now. Take your roof cap and untangle the various ties. There's 6 points on this cap. They invariably get tangled up. A bit like when you fitted the roof canvas, you position it at the door frame, lift the cap up onto the yurt as much as possible. And it's often useful if you've got a second person for this job as well, which is Bidwell here. Thank you. And so you ask your helper, Santa's little helper, to take this one, and they walk round to one side of the yurt. Your helper walks around to one side of the yurt and waits there. Between the two of you, you walk and drag the roof cap up and over the yurt. Next, get yourself a peg. For this yurt, there's 6. And this isn't a windy location, but if it was a windy location, you make sure they're quite well secured down. Tie the roof cap down securely so the wind and rain can't get in. At the bottom of the walls, there should be ties that pull the upstand of the ground sheet up, and then you've got a draft flap on the inside, and the sod cloth, which is on the outside of the walls, will keep the rain out, and then you should be nice and snug and warm in your yurt. So that concludes your instructional video. I hope it's helpful in the putting up of your yurt.